guys, I just arrived to the beautiful place in Bulgaria. It's called Panichiste. This is my hotel behind me. I'm decided to make this vlog and I'm going to reveal some of my traits so you'll be able to join the discussion while admiring the beautiful nature of Bulgaria. First, let's go to show you my room because it's really awesome. My car there standing all alone. The hotel is called Bandida, by the way, and it's really nice. So this is the room. I hope you can see it properly. This is the freaking awesome bed. It's king size. Well, so I hope it will be comfy. And let me show you my view. This is the beautiful view. Later on, we're going to have a walk and I'm going to show you a bit more of this beautiful place. Right, I'm just chilling on the terrace. I'm gonna film in a bit and we're gonna have a walk. Now I'm just going to give you a rough idea what you're going to see in this video. I'm going to comment on my last several losing traits. You know some of them, FTSE 100, the gold and the silver. And I'm also going to give you some future predictions about the trade on the oil, which we still have open. It's very beautiful here and really chilly, so I can stay here for a while. But you know, money never sleeps, so let's get to it. Really, really beautiful here. Well, you know, I have to bring up my trade about S&P 500. You know that it was one of my best for this year. What's important there to know that I did it right because I find the right spot, I follow the trend, and I hold it no matter of the correction and stuff. I just follow the plan and it turns out to be very good. And of course, we realize a very good profit from it. It's the same with the Dow Jones trade. We still have 30% there floating, but I guess I'm going to close them soon. But they were very similar. And here it's come the difference from the trades that I realized actually some losses. So, losing trades. Not the best topic, but we all have them. So we'll have to discuss them and try not to do the same mistakes again. About the FTSE, what I can tell you that I follow the same approach as what I... Whoa, that was close. I follow the same approach on what I did for the analysis for S&P 500. But what I did miscalculate it is that the downtrend in this situation was already exhausted. So I entered into the end of the downtrend and it was very probable for the price to retrace back. And it did. It was not only price action, there were other factors as well. One of it, as you may know, is that the of course the whoa, that was close again. One of it, as you may know, is that the UK economy, it's very dependable from the pound. Of course, everybody knows this, but there is a negative correlation. And it's really strong now about the Great British Pound and actually the FTSE 100 index. So the Brexit news were affecting very strongly the currency and it was reacting strongly. And of course, the index was reacting strongly as well. Due to the negative correlation, the index started to rise. And not only that, a lot of investment institutions raised their expectations for no Brexit deal, which is a good thing for the UK economy. And that's why the index started to retrace back and it's trying to get on the normal levels on which it was before several years. Maybe not several years, but let's say in the beginning of 2018. So what I did, as soon as I saw that the price is retracing back strongly, as you can now observe from the graph as well, I was waiting to check if after this big first huge candle there will be a price correction. I was expecting something called pump and dump. It didn't happen, so I exit immediately after this. I was hoping to close the position on break even. It didn't happen exactly like this. It just on a small loss, but there was, as I already told you, due to the fact that I was waiting for a certain formation on the graph which could give us the opportunity for eventual small profit. In my opinion, it worked it, so that's why I tried. As you can see from the continuation, it was a very, very good idea that we decided to close the position earlier, because as you can see, that was just the beginning of the uptrend. It started to move very strongly on the upside, and you see that it went through our stop loss, and it continues to rise up to this point as well. I know that most of the time I'm telling you that you have to follow your plan strict, but in this case it's a good idea that we were managing actively the trade, and we adjust according to the situation. What's next is the DAX trade. Most of you know that I was following the same tactic which I adopt for the FTSE 100 analysis, and of course, respectively, when I closed the FTSE 100, just immediately after this I closed the DAX trade as well on the same logic, and it went on even a smaller loss. On the chart you can see the whole development of the trade, but I'm not going to explain it to you on the details now, because you can check it in my last recap video from Friday. So whoever is interested, they can find all about this trade in our video. It's uploaded in our YouTube channel. Other trades that causes me some losses in January were on the metals gold and silver. Actually, there I was again playing on the short side, but my main idea was that the metals are negatively correlated to the markets, especially the precious metals. I saw a very similar formation on the gold and on the silver as well, so I decided to go for it. I entered short because I was already making a very good profit into the S&P 500 and into the trade on Dow Jones. But unfortunately, especially the silver trade started very good, but at some point it started to retrace back and it's starting to go against me. The trade on the gold, and now you're going to be able to observe all both of the graph. The gold trade was consolidating just below my sell zone, so that was giving me confidence that on the next wave on the short side it might reach my lock profit area, but unfortunately it didn't happen like this. As you can see from the graph, it started to retrace back very strongly, but here I decided to hold, and I was just following my plan because all the markets were going high, so I was like, maybe this is just taking profit movement from the guys that were shorting before, and this buying pressure will end and the wave on the short side will continue. But as you can see, it didn't happen like this. It continues to rise and hits my stop loss. On the silver trade, the thing that you can observe on the graph is that it fell back down more than the gold, so it didn't hit my stop loss on the first wave up. So as you can see, the second candlestick, which is after the big correction on the long side, is something like a small red doji. So I decided that I might wait for a correction. The buying pressure is exhausted, so it might fell back down. We could close it on break even, or even the downtrend could continue. But again, the same thing, I was too greedy, I was holding too much, and on the next day the upward trend continues and again hits my stop loss. At this situation, I don't think that it was wrong to follow my plan, but maybe I had to be more careful, and I had to follow the volume more, because on the downtrend it was very weak, so this should have given me the idea that the correction on the long side will be stronger and there will be a continuation. I ignored these signals and I paid the price. And now for the oil trade. As you can see from the graph, I still holding it. The consolidation was longer than I was expecting, but the downtrend seems exhausted, and I'm expecting soon a very strong buying pressure which will push the price to our lock profit area. Of course, there might be changes, so I'm managing the trade actively. But you know, from the graph, everything looks good for now, and I'm expecting the OPEC meeting and of course the crude oil inventory to see how they're going to affect the price. But I'm optimistic that this is the beginning of an uptrend, and we're going to be able to cover most of the losses here and even to go on a profit. But now, enough for trading. I'm on a very beautiful place that I wanted to show you since the beginning, so let's go and check. Thank you. this wooden construction is quite tall actually, and it's for the people to check for fires in the woods. But guess what? Now we are going up. So in a conclusion, I'm going to say to you that yes, you have to follow your plan strict and not to do anything stupid on the markets, but of course you have to be flexible and you have to adjust according to the situation. Now I'm going to leave you to admire the beautiful nature of Bulgaria and Panichiste.